What is up, people? Welcome back to the channel. First off, Let's Talk Thomas will continue. I'm not dropping it. I'm just trying something new. Moving on. Aardman Animation is a popular British film producing company who, in the past few years, have pumped out beloved productions such as Wallace and Gromit and Chicken Run. However, due to a number of aspects, the products of Aardman Animation have, in a way, gone under the radar, in comparison to other mainstream television. Despite this, there is an exception, likely the first of Aardman's to really hit it off worldwide. Today, I, the Pannier Jester, I'm going to take a few minutes to talk about one of the most creative and out there claymations on the face of the globe, Shaun the Sheep. So, one of you might be wondering, where did this video come from? Which is a reasonable question. I'm a Thomas channel talking about this goofy farmer and all his sheep. Well, all the way back in August 2021, I made a thumbnail for a potential Shaun the Sheep video for the second channel, which I don't post on regularly at all, actually. I started planning out the video and, unknown to myself until now, actually finished scripting it. But on a reread, I can see why this thing never came to be. Script ain't great. But in the process of editing, I never got further than the thumbnail. So that sat on the back burner for a while, when recently I came across this video by Smarty Pants, link in the description, in which he talked about Wallace and Gromit, Curse of the Were-Rabbit, and a lot of what made it quite the interesting topic of discussion. And my motivation meter skyrocketed. So, here we are. Alright, history lesson over. Let's talk about sheep. This show is awesome. Shaun the Sheep is this gimmicky stop-motion animated show about the hijinks of various cynical farm animals. And it's got nearly everything one could desire in a lighthearted show about such. A lovable cast, Shaun, the spunked-up leader of the flock, Bitzer, the enforcing dog, Farmer, the clueless middle-aged farmer, Timmy, the child who somehow got his own show, Shirley, the one I misgendered for 11 years, among others. The score. With the musical soundtrack composed by Ilan Eshkuri, the same person who composed Wallace and Gromit's score, you can't really go wrong. I personally have gotten a good amount of use out of this soundtrack, as it's prominently featured in the Endless Runaway Pilot episode and Frosty Feet. It's got style, it's got humor, it's got class. But it's also Aardman. I mean, a good amount of what they do is kinda awesome. Despite that, Shaun the Sheep has shown more popularity and financial growth than anything Aardman has made since its debut to television, despite it originating as a small TV show. Not to say Shaun the Sheep is out of its league, but it's a gem in a cave full of shinier and duller gems. So the question is, why? Why has Shaun the Sheep grown to be so popular in its existence? How has it become more marketable and desirable by people all over the world? Well, let's take it back to basics. Shaun the Sheep is so different to any show that I've ever seen, which is something anyone could say about anything Aardman. Their whole gimmick is different. But I'm gonna go one step further in saying that it is significantly different than any Aardman film that I've ever seen before. So much so that when I first saw the show, deadass, I thought my CD was broken because there was zero dialogue. The utter lack of dialogue is one of the most noteworthy things in Shaun the Sheep. Now, don't get the wrong idea, it's not like every character is just mute, there's implied dialogue. But it's substituted for general, incomprehensible grunts, groans, sighs, and baas. Justin Fletcher, the voice of Shaun, Timmy, and a few of the other sheep, goes more in-depth about this in this very in-depth video on the Aardman channel, which I would recommend, it's pretty good. Now, have I ever seen this as a bad thing? Yes, when I was like 7, because
yeah, I don't know what they're saying. How am I supposed to follow the story, man?
But now my point of view on the matter has changed drastically. Yes, there is no dialogue, but there doesn't need to be. Shaun the Sheep is structured to the point where dialogue can be very easily substituted with body language, various music cues, and implied dialogue. Which directly leads me to my next point. The overarching reason Shaun the Sheep was a massive hit was because it appealed to people internationally. Listen, I love Aardman, but England can only get you so far. which is why they've made dubs of their content for other countries. But a good amount of Aardman films are what one could consider notably British. Rightfully British, but notably British. British slang, British terms, British architect. It is a British company owned by British people. Of course, what they produce is going to be just a little bit British. Which I don't have a problem with. Not all the time. But let's be realistic here. If something made in England doesn't thrive in America, then it's probably not going to thrive in, like, France or frickin' Austria. Smarty Pants made a good point about this in his video. Wallace and Gromit: Curse of the Were-Rabbit didn't perform all too well in America. Those who saw it overall thought it was great, but those in question were considerably few. An obviously British film coming to an obviously not British country, yeah, it didn't pan out great. This effect varies in Aardman films, but the overall consensus has been Britishness is a little too much. There are exceptions to this, but the biggest by far being Shaun the Sheep. A general audience drawn to Shaun the Sheep saw this. A whole bunch of sheep, and this dog. Sure, the people look mad goofy, but the main characters are all half normal looking animals. So yeah, simple claymation about animals. Appeal jump, instantly. Along with a simple conceptual visual, the fact that there's no dialogue has helped Shaun the Sheep in the long run. British words, phrases, and other bits of pip pip cheerio are all blotted out by the grunts and other bodily noises. Heck, the only language barrier between countries is the intro. No questions about it, Shaun the Sheep takes place in modern day. Now the farm, aka the main setting, isn't mad modern, but it's a farm, that's the expectation. Shaun and his gang have gone to places that look like people could actively be in right now. And the overall familiar setting of the show only drew people in further. Shaun the Sheep is so out there, yet so tame, and honestly, I can't get enough of it. I absolutely adore the show. However, this isn't to say it's any more outstanding than the other Aardman productions. Though, numbers don't lie. And overall, the way Shaun the Sheep presented itself to the general public ultimately made it the most successful thing Aardman's pumped out in its time. Not to say that Shaun the Sheep should serve as the all-in Aardman sample for a good story. The creators over there are way too capable for that to be the case, but it's a gem of its own, and I think it deserves a half-decent amount of praise for being one of the only Aardman productions to truly make it big worldwide.